Hi everyone. In this video, we'll discuss how to test the construct reliability for our SCM model. In DAV726, we have used Chromebox Alpha to test the construct reliability. Chromebox Alpha is a very popular method in testing the reliability and is also a recommended method. In this video, I introduce to you another method of testing the construct reliability using CFA outputs. This method, also called construct reliability or composite reliability CR, is described in HERD or 2010. This is the formula for CR. This formula uses the standardized factor loadings and the error variance from CFA outputs. A CR value greater than or equal to 0.7 indicates good construct reliability. Let's examine the formula. For the numerator, we have the square of sum of standardized factor loadings of that construct. For the denominator, we have that square of sum of factor loadings plus sum of error variance. We will calculate CR for each construct. To calculate CR, we will use Excel. First, we go to CFA outputs, select estimates, and copy the standardized factor loadings. To do so, we right-click on this area and select copy. Then we paste these values to the Excel spreadsheet. I will change this to loadings to avoid confusion. Another information we need is error variance. We scroll down until we see variance section, which shows variance for both factors and error terms. We will not use the variance of factors. We copy these values and paste them to the same Excel spreadsheet. We will extract only the error variance from this table by highlighting these values, copy and paste them up here along with the factor loadings. One important thing is that we need to make sure the error terms match with the items. In this case, they match well, but you should know that in some other cases, they may not fully match, especially when you add a new item to the model. So you always have to double check. I will add a title for this column and call it error. Let's look at the formula again. The first step is to get some factor loadings and then square it. I add a title for the next column and call it sum loadings square. To get this value, we need to enter an equation to Excel. Equal sign, parenthesis, sum function, parenthesis, then highlight all factor loadings for F1, close parenthesis again, cap sign, 2 to get the square, and hit enter. This is a sum of square factor loadings for F1. To avoid mixed up between factors, I add green shade to all items for F2. We do the same for F2. Equal sign, parenthesis, sum function, parenthesis, then highlight all factors loadings for F2, close parenthesis again, cap sign 2 and hit enter. And repeat the same step for F3. Equal sign, parenthesis, sum function, parenthesis, and then highlight all factor loadings for F3, close parenthesis again, cap sign 2 and hit enter. Let's go back to CR formula. We have the square sum of factor loadings. We'll need the sum of error variance. You can have another column for that if you want, but in this case, the formula is simple, so I will go ahead with calculating CR. I add another column and call it CR. Equal sign, select the square sum of loadings for F1. In this case, it is cell F4. Divide sign, parenthesis, cell F4 again, plus sum function, parenthesis, highlight error variance for F1, which is cell E4 to E12, close parenthesis, and hit enter. And here is the CR value for F1, 0.77. We'll repeat the same step for F2, equal sign, select the square sum of loadings for F2. In this case, it is cell F13, divide signs, parenthesis, cell F13 again, plus sum function, parenthesis, highlight error variance for F2, which is cell E13 to E17, close parenthesis, and hit enter. The CR value for F2 is 0.569. Similarly, we can calculate CR value for F3. Equal sign, select the square sum of loadings for F3. In this case, it is cell F18, divide sign, parenthesis, cell F18 again, plus sum function, parenthesis, highlight error variance for F3, which is cell E18 to E24, close parenthesis, and hit enter. The CR value for F3 is 0.7. Let's examine CR values. The CR value for F1 is 0.77, which indicates good construct reliability. CR value for F2 is 0.569, which is not satisfactory. CR value for F3 is 0.7, indicating good reliability. Overall, F1 and F3 have good construct reliability. On the other hand, F2 has poor construct reliability. The reason could be due to low factor loadings for item 12, 15, and 5, which are below 0.5. To improve the construct reliability of this construct, you may need to review these items and decide to delete one item and see how it will improve the factor loading and the CR value. In addition, it is also recommended to report both CR values and Kronbach's alpha. If Kronbach's alpha value is satisfactory, we can argue that the construct has acceptable reliability. Remember that SEM is a theory-driven method, so before deleting any item, we always need to examine the content of that item and check with the literature to see if it makes sense to remove that item. That is how to calculate construct reliability value using AMOS output and Excel. Thank you, and bye now.